Coming up next is what really happens if you have this type of design oil catch can and you drive in really cold climate during winter. So this oil catch can is fairly cheap, and it's called KKMoon or KKMoon, should it be more accurate, and it's a nearly carbon copy of the Mishimoto oil catch can, and a comparison between this copy of the Mishimoto oil catch can and the actual Mishimoto oil catch can you can find here. So I mean, it's aluminium body. I'm not really doing a review of it, but it's just showing what's inside. So this is the bottom. It's fairly small amount, so it's probably 100 mil or so. So really has a, so the input it comes from here and the output comes from here. So the input hits this metal plate. It kind of goes around, so there is a baffle. Once this gets full, it doesn't really slosh around and come up there, so you can rotate this. And this is the output, so this goes from the output. So if I undo this, this is really a bronze filter, and apparently it has a so this is just the hole and goes that side. So really this bronze filter is 50 microns, so it's pretty really very fine bronze filter. So what happens really if during winter, and this of course will have quite a bit of water vapor in there, not only oil but also oil vapor when it filters the oil. So I decided to test that and do a kind of a simulation of this and see what happens. So what I've really decided to do is just dip this filter into water. And then put it back on, screw it back on the oil catch can, the filter, then put it in the freezer for a couple of hours, and then see if one can actually blow and this can really, the air can still go through, so the crankcase gases can still go through the oil catch can. But first is, let's see the actual operation of the oil catch can, and how I can show you, instead of me blowing, how I can show you how this goes through. So how I'm gonna test if actually the oil catch can work. So I have a syringe that I've hooked up to the in port. So if you take it in and push it without a problem, it goes around. But if I stop one of the ports, and if I push it, so there is resistance, this really comes back on its own. And the air comes out. So let's do it again. So now it works. So I'll open it up, dip the filter in water, put it back together, put it for a couple of hours in the fridge, and then do the same experiment to see if actually crankcase gases can go around if the temperature is, I think my freezer is minus 16, so let's see what happens if the outside temperature is minus 16 degrees. Okay, so this is out of the freezer. It's been 1.5 hours. You can see how frosty it is, so I'll try to push this fairly quickly. So now for the test, let's see if this really goes. It comes back completely. Thank you. So basically in it's already defrosted. It's been like 5-10 minutes. So the air doesn't really go through, doesn't really come back. So if I do the same with pressing here, I mean, I can so it kind of comes back once you press. There is creates quite a bit of pressure, so it does work once it's defrosted. But there we have it. Let me open it slightly. It's not yet, it's probably defrosted fairly quickly. Yeah, it has defrosted completely. A few drops in here and there. So that's the end result. If you really have this design of oil catch can, this Mishimoto design with this bronze filter, and if you really drive, leave your car overnight and it's minus whatever couple of degrees centigrade, this will, well, maybe a bit lower than that, this will probably freeze, and then on the first crank of the engine this would not defrost that quickly, so there is the potential to block seals, to blow seals and oil and so on. So because the first crank there is a lot more space in the cylinders, so there is a lot more blow by at startup, so this will fairly quickly disrupt that. So this is the end result. This is the conclusion. So if you really have this design, think about perhaps replacing with something else that doesn't really have that many fine bronze filters for winter. For summer it's perfect. If you never really see negative temperatures, degrees centigrade, then it's absolutely fine. So thank you very much indeed for watching. Hopefully that's useful to someone, and subscribe. Let me know if any comments in the comment section. Thank you.